Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Microbiology with Sumi. If you like my videos, please like, share and subscribe to my channel. Today's video is on MVIC biochemical test. So let's start with it. Let's start with introduction. MVIC biochemical test is a set of four biochemical tests and these tests are performed individually. So this test, MVIC biochemical test, is a combination of four tests and each test is performed individually. So let's see. Each letter of MVIC test stands for individual test. I stands for indole production test. M stands for methyl red test. V stands for Voges-Proskauer test. C stands for citrate utilization test, and I, lowercase I, is used for ease of pronunciation, that is MVIC test. Now, so let's see this test one by one. I'm going to discuss about indole production test. So let's see indole production test. So what is the aim of this test? The aim of this test is to determine the capacity of bacterial culture to produce indole. See, this MVIC test, they are carried out for detection of Enterobacteriaceae family. Okay, the bacteria which belong to Enterobacteriaceae family are detected by using this MVIC test. So, in indole test, we are going to determine the capacity of bacteria to produce indole. Now, what are the requirements? First, we require bacterial culture. Second is tryptophan broth. Third is coax reagent or Ehrlich reagent. Further, we need xylene. So, these are the requirements. Now, here, let's see the composition of media and reagents. The first one is tryptophan broth. So, in tryptophan broth, we require 1 gram tryptone, 100 ml distilled water. Second is coax reagent. So coax reagent is made from p-dimethylaminobenzaldehyde, that we need 15 grams. Isoamyl alcohol, in that is 150 ml. HCl, that is hydrogen chloride, we need 75 ml. And the third reagent is Ehrlich reagent. So here we require p-dimethylaminobenzaldehyde, that is 1 gram, and 95% ethanol. Here we take this ethanol, 95 ml, and concentrated HCl, 20 ml. So you have to prepare this reagents very carefully. Let's start with the procedure. First, tryptophan broth is prepared, distributed in the test tubes and sterilized by autoclaving. So here, first of all, according to the composition of tryptophan broth, we have to prepare the tryptophan broth, distribute it in test tubes and sterilize it by autoclaving. Now, for autoclaving is means sterilization at 121 degree Celsius for 15 minutes. Now, after sterilization, these tryptophan broth tubes are inoculated with loop full of suspension and incubated at 37 degrees Celsius for 24 hours. Further, after incubation, 3 to 4 drops of xylene is added in the tubes. Then the tubes are shaken vigorously. Further, these tubes are kept still so that two layers get separated. So after adding xylene, we have to shake the tubes vigorously so it get properly mixed with the medium. After shaking the tubes, we have to keep the tube steady for some time till the two layers get separated. Further, after separation of two layers, 1 ml of coax reagent or Ehrlich reagent is added in the tubes and observation of pink color ring is done. So if the test is positive, we get a pink coloring formation. So this is our observation. Now let's see the mechanism. Here, first of all, indole is an aromatic heterocyclic organic compound. Okay. Now, indole can be produced by some members of Enterobacteriaceae family by hydrolysis of tryptophan. As I told you before, MVIC test is carried out for determination of Enterobacteriaceae family. Okay. And this Enterobacteriaceae family has the ability to hydrolyze tryptophan. Okay. So here we are using tryptophan broth. Okay. And indole is produced by this Enterobacteriaceae family, and this indole hydrolyzes this tryptophan that is present in the tryptophan broth. Further, indole production is a protein utilization test. Here we are going to use a protein rich medium, that is tryptophan rich broth, and this medium contains tryptophan as a source of protein. Okay, now see, first of all, indole production test, it is a protein utilization test. Here we provide protein to the bacteria, and that protein is tryptophan. So the source of protein in this media is tryptophan. Further, the bacterial cells are able to produce tryptophanase enzyme that hydrolyze and deaminate tryptophan into indole, pyruvate and amino acid. So what happens when these bacteria, they are exposed to tryptophan? Now this bacteria of Enterobacteriaceae family have an ability to produce tryptophanase enzyme. Okay, this tryptophanase enzyme, what they do, they hydrolyze and deaminate the tryptophan that is present in the media and convert this tryptophan into indole, pyruvate and ammonia. Further, these degraded products, that is that three products which we get after hydrolysis of tryptophan, these degraded products are treated with Covax reagent or Ehrlich reagent. Okay, further they are treated with this reagents in presence of heat. Heat means you have to simply simply expose that test tube to the heat on your burner. Slightly you have to warm that test tube in which your broth is present. Now, if the degraded products in the test tube contains indole, then this indole reacts with Covax reagent or Ehrlich reagent and form pink color rose indole complex. Now, this is the way to determine indole production. Okay, now see what happens if the test is positive, then the bacteria have produced indole. Okay, now if indole is present in that fermented tube, that indole is going to react with this reagent. Now here we are going to add Covax or Ehrlich reagent. Now indole and this reagent, any one of this reagent, they get combined together and form a complex. And this complex is called as pink color rose indole complex. And here this pink color ring is developed, and that determines the test as positive. That is, indole is produced. Now, here is an important note. Indole is soluble in organic compounds. Okay. So it is recommended to add xylene, chloroform or ether. By adding this substance, indole get extracted from the whole medium and forms a separate layer on the surface of the medium, so that Covax reagent or Ehrlich reagent can easily react with indole and form a pink color complex. So at second step after incubation period, we add xylene. Okay, we can add any of this organic compound. We can add xylene, chloroform or ether. Now when we add xylene, what happens? This xylene, it extracts indole from that fermented broth. It forms a separate layer. So this separate layer, when further it is treated with Covax or Ehrlich reagent, it can easily get reacted to that indol and form pink color ring. So this is the role of xylene. Further result, if there is a formation of pink color ring, then the indol production test is positive, and if there is no ring formation, then the indol test is negative. So here you can see the observation. Here in the positive test, you can see two layers are separated and a pink color ring is formed. This shows the presence of indol. And here this is a negative test where there is no indol formation. And result, as I have told you before, if there is a formation of pink color ring, then the indol production test is positive. And if there is no ring formation, then the test is negative. 1. Methyl red test. This is the second biochemical test in MVIC test. Let's start with it. Methyl red test. The aim of this biochemical test is to carry out the methyl red test to determine the fermentation capacity of given bacterial cell. So here we are going to determine the capacity of fermentation of the given bacterial cell. Now, what type of fermentation is carried out? Which fermentation is carried out? I will explain you further. So let's see the requirements. Here we need glucose phosphate broth, methyl red indicator, test culture, and the media composition of glucose phosphate broth is, we need 0.5 gram glucose, K2HPO4 0.5 grams, peptone 0.5 grams, and distilled water 100 ml. And the pH is adjusted to the neutral, that is 7. Let's see the procedure of methyl red biochemical test. Here, glucose phosphate broth is prepared and distributed in test tubes. These test tubes are further sterilized by autoclaving. So first of all, what we have to do, according to the media composition, we have to prepare glucose phosphate broth. After preparing this broth, we have to distribute this broth in test tubes. Okay, and after distribution, we have to completely wrap the test tubes properly, plug it properly, wrap it properly, and then we have to sterilize it by autoclaving. That is, sterilize at temperature of 121 degrees Celsius for 15 minutes. Now, after sterilization, these test tubes are inoculated with the test culture, that is the given bacterial suspension, and incubated at 37 degrees Celsius for 24 hours. Now, after incubation, what is done? After incubation, we have to take the test tubes, add 5 drops of methyl red indicator. And after adding this indicator, the medium is, or we can say the tubes are observed for development of a red color. Now, let's see the mechanism of methyl red test. Now, MVIC test, Enterobacteriaceae family. See, I will tell you a short introduction about MVIC test. MVIC test is a set of 4 biochemical tests that are carried out for identification of Enterobacteriaceae family members. That is the identification of that bacteria which belong to this family. Now, it contains 4 tests and each test is carried out individually. Now, here in the methyl red test, in the aim we saw ki we are going to determine the capacity of microorganisms to carry out fermentation. Okay, and here the fermentation that is involved is formic acid fermentation. Now, what happens? See, now in this test we are going to use glucose phosphate broth. Okay, so this broth contains glucose as a source of energy. So glucose is a raw material for microorganisms. This glucose is converted into pyruvic acid and further it is converted into formic acid. So here the raw material for that bacteria is glucose. Now, if that organisms belong, if that bacteria belong to Enterobacteriaceae family, they will carry out this fermentation. They will convert glucose to pyruvic acid and form a product to formic acid.
Now, formic acid fermentation is of two types. First is mixed acid fermentation and second is 2-butanediol fermentation. Okay. Now, in mixed acid fermentation, it is carried out by E. coli, Salmonella and Proteus. These are the bacteria which carry out this fermentation. And the byproducts, or we can say the products that are obtained, are succinic acid, formic acid, acetic acid and lactic acid. And the second type of fermentation, it is carried out by Bacillus, Enterobacteriaceae, Serratia. So these are the bacteria that carry out this second type of fermentation. Now, in second type of fermentation, what happens? Pyruvate is converted into acetylmethylcarbonyl. And further, this acetylmethylcarbonyl is converted into butanediol. So this is formed. So this is the main mechanism. Now, further, what happens? Further, when we compare these two fermentation processes, the first one, that is the mixed acid fermentation process, produces mixed acid products. Okay, so it produces many acids. Now, which results? It increases the acidity of fermentation media. So, it acidifies the media and the pH moves towards the acidic side. Now, here, mixed acid fermentation process produces sufficient amount of acids, which can be detected by methyl red indicator. So, here we are using methyl red indicator for determination of acid production. Now, how it is done? See, here we use glucose phosphate broth as an incubation medium. Okay. Now, this medium is highly buffered and a small amount of acid is produced. The media can resist the change in pH. So, here for fermentation, we are going to use glucose phosphate broth, and this media is buffered. Buffered, the role of buffer is to resist the change in pH. The small amount of change is adjusted by the buffer. It tries to keep the value, or we can say tries to keep the pH at a particular point. Now, this small amount of pH is resisted by the buffer. So, this small change can't be detected by methyl red indicator. A sufficient amount of acid should be present in that medium so that it can be detected by this methyl red indicator. Now, the pH range of methyl red is 4.4 pH. It shows red color. So, in acidic side, that is at pH 4.4, when this methyl red is added in the media, it will show red color. And if the pH of the media is 6.2, then the methyl red shows yellow color. So, this is the pH range. For at acidic pH, methyl red shows red color, and at alkaline side, we can say, or not at alkaline side, or nearly at neutral side, it shows yellow color. So, after incubation, the pH indicator, methyl red, and the medium is observed for change in color. Now, if acid is produced in the medium and after addition of methyl red, the media shows red color, then the methyl red test is positive. And the methyl red test is shown positive in case of mixed acid fermentation, as the complex mixture of acid is produced. Here, it is a simple thing. If the bacteria is carrying out this fermentation process, it is carrying out the first type of fermentation process, that is mixed acid fermentation process, it results in formation of various acids. And due to formation of various acids, the pH of the medium shifts to acidic side. That is, the pH may shift to 4.4 or below that. And if the pH is at acidic side, then this methyl red, when we add methyl red, it will give a red color to the media. And this indicates the positive test. Let's see the observation. Here in the diagrammatic representation, you can see there are two test tubes. One is positive, that is red color tube, and the second one is negative, that is pale yellow color tube. So, after incubation and addition of methyl red, if red color develops in the test tube, then the test is positive due to presence of acids. And if there is no development of red color, then the tube is negative. So let's see the result. If a stable red color is developed in the media after addition of methyl red indicator, then the MR test is positive. So this red color, it should be stable, it should last longer, it should not disappear. If it lasts longer, or we can say if a stable red color is developed, then the test is positive.
Voges-Proskauer VP test. This is one of the MVIC biochemical test. As we know, MVIC test is a set of four tests that are carried out for determination of members of family Enterobacteriaceae. So Voges-Proskauer test is the third test of MVIC test, and each test in MVIC test is carried out individually. So this is the third test. Now let's see VP test in detail. Voges-Proskauer test. This test is also called as VP test. So let's see the aim. The aim of this test is to determine the capacity of bacterial culture to carry out fermentation. Now, first of all, Enterobacteriaceae family, they carry out formic acid fermentation, which I have explained in detail in my previous video, that is methyl red biochemical test. In short, I will explain you. See, this formic acid fermentation is of two types. First one is mixed acid fermentation, and second is 2-butanaldehyde fermentation. Here in this test, we are going to determine the capacity of this culture that carry out second type of fermentation, that is 2-butanaldehyde fermentation. Now let's see the requirements. First one is glucose phosphate broth. Second, we require 5% alcoholic alpha naphthol. Third one is 40% KOH. Fourth one is test culture. So these are the requirements. Let's see the procedure. Glucose phosphate broth is prepared and distributed in test tubes. These test tubes are further sterilized by autoclaving. So according to the media composition, we have to prepare glucose phosphate broth. Then we have to distribute this broth in test tubes, and then further sterilize these test tubes by autoclaving. Now after sterilization, these test tubes are inoculated with the test culture in aseptic conditions and incubated at 37 degrees Celsius for 24 hours. Now after incubation, 0.6 ml of alpha naphthol and 0.2 ml of KOH solution per ml of culture broth media is added. Okay, now see, first of all, after incubation, what is done? These two things are added, that is 0.6 ml alpha naphthol, 0.2 ml KOH. Now this is added for per ml, that is if your media is 1 ml, you have to add this quantity. And if your media is 10 ml, according to 10 ml, you have to add this quantity of these two chemicals, that is alpha naphthol and KOH. Now further, after addition of these two reagents, the culture tubes are shaken properly, that is they are mixed properly and kept in the slanting position to increase aeration. Okay, so the test tubes are, they should be kept in the slanting position. You have to remember this, or else if you will keep them flat, all your media is going to come in your cotton plug and it is going to be wasted. All your experiment is going to be wasted. So you have to keep it in slanting position to increase the aeration. And now keep these tubes in slanting position for 1 hour. So you have to keep these tubes for at least 1 hour so that you get a proper result. And after 1 hour, you have to note down the result. Now let's see the mechanism in detail. There are two types of fermentations that are carried out by members of Enterobacteriaceae family. As I told you before, Enterobacteriaceae family members carry out formic acid fermentation in two ways. Further, in methyl red test, we detect the mixed acid fermentation,
And here in Voges Proskauer test, we are going to determine butanediol fermentation by detection of product that is acetone. So acetone is a fermented product that is obtained by Enterobacteriaceae family. So in short, in VP test, we are going to determine the production of acetoin. If acetoin is produced, then our test is positive. So this acetoin is a precursor of butanediol, and it is produced during butanediol fermentation. Now in VP test, after fermentation, the media is treated with alpha naphthol and KOH solution, due to which acetoin is oxidized to diacetyl. Now see, as you may be remembering that in the procedure I have told that after incubation we have to add these two solutions, that is alpha naphthol and KOH, and keep our test tubes in a slanting position for at least 1 hour. So during this procedure, what happens that this acetoin gets oxidized to diacetyl, and now this diacetyl reacts with the peptone that is present in the broth and produce pink color. Now once the diacetyl is formed, it starts to react with the peptone that is already present in the broth, and these two things, they give formation of pink color. So here alternately we come into conclusion that there is a presence of acetoin. So when we add these two products, the acetoin gets oxidized to diacetyl and it reacts with the peptone. So we get a pink color. So if we obtain a pink color, that means the media, it contained acetoin. So after we get a pink color, the conclusion is that our VP test is positive. Let's see the observation. This is the test tube before incubation and these are the test tubes after incubation. The positive test tube indicates formation of acetoin and oxidation of diacetyl. This diacetyl reacts with the peptone and there is a change in color of the media. And in the negative test tube, there is no formation of acetoin. So this is the observation. And the result is the formation of pink color indicates the presence of acetoin and confirms butanediol fermentation and indicates VP test as positive.
Citrate utilization test. Citrate utilization test is the fourth test from MVIC test. So let's start with it. So first, aim. The aim of this experiment is to carry out citrate utilization test to determine the ability of a bacterial cell to utilize citrate. So let's see the requirements. Here we need Simon's citrate agar and test culture. So the composition of Simon's citrate agar is 0.2 grams sodium citrate, 0.002 grams magnesium sulfate, 0.5 grams sodium chloride, 0.1 gram ammonium dihydrogen phosphate, 0.1 gram dipotassium phosphate, 0.008 grams bromothymol blue, 3 grams agar agar, 100 ml distilled water, and the pH is 7. Now let's see the procedure. The Simon's agar is prepared according to the given composition, sterilized, and after sterilization, the slants of this media are prepared. Now, first of all, we have to prepare the Simon's citrate agar, sterilize it, and prepare slants in the test tubes. Further, these slants are streaked heavily and incubated for 24 hours at 37 degrees Celsius. After incubation, the slant is observed for change in color and the results are recorded. Now let's see the mechanism of citrate utilization test. The members of Enterobacteriaceae family have the ability to obtain energy and carbon by utilization of citrate. So the members, or we can say the bacteria that belong to Enterobacteriaceae family, are capable of obtaining energy and carbon from citrate.
Now, this is an important characteristic to identify the members of Enterobacteriaceae family. Further, in citrate utilization test, the test culture is exposed to a media which contains citrate as a sole source of carbon and energy. So, Simon citrate agar contains only one source of carbon and energy, and that is citrate. Further, if the bacterial cells are able to produce enzyme citrate permease, then the bacterial cells are able to utilize citrate. So, the members of Enterobacteriaceae family are able to produce the enzyme that is called as citrate permease. Only the bacteria which are able to prepare this enzyme or produce this enzyme are capable of utilizing citrate, because this enzyme citrate permease is able to transport citrate in the cell, and further cell can utilize this citrate. So when the cell will be able to utilize this citrate, when this citrate enters or when it gets permeated in the cell. If this citrate is not permeated, they will not be able to utilize it, and the transport of this citrate is done by the enzyme citrate permease. So the bacteria which are able to produce this enzyme are only able to utilize citrate as a sole source of carbon and energy. Here in citrate utilization test, we need citrate agar that contains ammonium phosphate as a source of nitrogen, sodium citrate as a source of carbon, and bromothymol blue as a pH indicator. Further, bromothymol blue is yellow at acidic pH and blue at alkaline pH. So, bromothymol blue is an indicator dye. At acidic pH, this dye turns yellow in color, and at alkaline pH, this dye is blue in color. Now, in citrate utilization test, we use agar slants, because for this test, oxygen is required, and after oxidation of citrate, CO2 is liberated. Now see, here we are using agar slants, so the media and the bacteria both use the available oxygen, and they get oxygen. So what happens? The oxidation of citrate takes place and formation of CO2 takes place. So when this CO2 is liberated, further this CO2 reacts with sodium and water, which is already present in the media, and forms sodium carbonate. Now, as we all know, sodium carbonate is an alkaline product. Now, because of production of sodium carbonate, which is an alkaline product, the pH of the media shifts to alkaline side. Now, on the other hand, the bacteria utilize ammonium citrate and release nitrogen with the production of ammonia and convert it to ammonium hydroxide, and this is the other alkaline product. So here what happens? On other side, when this bacteria utilize ammonium citrate, they release nitrogen and produce ammonia. Now here what happens? These get converted into ammonium hydroxide, and further ammonium hydroxide is also an alkaline product, and due to which again the pH is shifted to alkaline side. Now this alkaline product increases pH of the media to alkaline side, and thus the color of the media changes to blue color. Hence the change in color of the media to blue indicates positive citrate utilization test. So only the members of the family Enterobacteriaceae are able to utilize this citrate. They form two products. The first one is sodium carbonate. Okay. This sodium carbonate is an alkaline product, and the second product they form is ammonium hydroxide. Now these two products are alkaline products. They shift the pH of the media to alkaline side, and which in changes the color to blue color, and development of blue color indicates the positive citrate utilization test. Now this is the observation in positive test tube. You can see the development of blue color, and the result Formation of a deep blue color indicates positive citrate utilization test, and the test culture has an ability to utilize citrate. So if there is a formation of deep blue color, it indicates positive citrate utilization test, and whichever culture we are using for carrying out this test is able to utilize citrate. And utilization of citrate is the most important, one of the most important feature of Enterobacteriaceae family. So thank you for watching my video. If you like my video, please like, share and subscribe to my channel.